Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your most favorite brother from another mother, coming to you from the fabulous Philippines. I'm only laughing because in the world, maybe some people might think any place in the world is fabulous, but in the eyes of God, it's all Sodom and Gomorrah these days, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I don't come to you in my own name, but I come to you today in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. For there is victory, victory, victory in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. I praise God because since I flew to the Philippines and entered back in to this super unchristian place. Hallelujah. Those of you who watch my videos, the Philippines is about 5 to 10% born again Christian. Even though the United States, we have pockets of very evil, we do have very Christian places, some places in the United States. Brothers and sisters, since I entered into Manila and I was there in Manila, brothers and sisters, the Lord used me to do a deliverance there. I've done some deliverances here. And since then, when I was in Manila, the Lord spoke to me, brothers and sisters. And I saw the angel of the Lord with a mighty sword riding a mighty steed. And the word of the Lord came to me, and the Lord said, I am vanquishing mine enemies. This is the beginning of the vanquishing of mine enemies. And brothers and sisters, just tonight, you know, the Lord spoke to me that two or three times. I've had massive, you know, birth pains around me. And then the ministry here in Joshua's ministry and all around me of the enemies. Since I was in Manila, the Lord has allowed me to see in the spirit. The Lord has given me a new one of the gifts of the Spirit from 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and that's a spiritual discernment, discerning of spirits, brothers and sisters. And that means to be able to see into the spirit world, or hear into the spirit world, or smell, and you know, through our senses that, hey, this person's demon-possessed. There's demons over there. And before I only knew by words of wisdom or words of knowledge, but now the Lord has given me, by His grace, this new deliverance, a breaking forth in deliverance. And praise God, because I've done many deliverances. I think about 10 or 12 deliverances I've done over my years, 17 years in the ministry, but now the Lord has anointed me for that. So I praise God. And Brother Terry in Australia, also, hallelujah, the Lord has been moving him in toward a deliverance ministry. And praise God, we're going to do it for the Lord by the grace of God. So anyway, the tribulation period is what? The Lord vanquishing his enemies. Hallelujah. Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Watchmen arise, let his enemies be scattered. Prophets arise, let his enemies be scattered. Church arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let the church arise and let his enemies be scattered. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Don't fall for the words of people, the soft, silky words of people telling you, you know, well, it's time for the rapture and don't worry about it. Jesus said the gates of hell should not prevail against his church. So don't you let the gates of hell prevail against you because you're going up against what the Lord said. Hallelujah. Let God be truth and every man a liar. Did God not say it? Will he also not do it? Did God not say it? Is he also not able to perform it? These are all Bible verses I'm quoting, brothers and sisters. Most of the things I say are Bible verses, and I usually don't sometimes stop to say, hey, it's a Bible verse. Sometimes I don't. But I got a text the Lord wants to read me to read to you, and the text about the vanquishing of his enemies, just before I made this video, the Lord spoke to me to use the Google, and actually in the King James it doesn't use that term, so the Lord told me to Google it, vanquish mine enemies, and it came up from a different version. I think it's the Message or something. It doesn't matter. It's a liberal translation, but the text that the Lord wanted me to see was from there. Psalm 143 verse 12, that the Lord, because of his love for us, his love for me, his love for you, like Psalm 91, why does the Lord deliver us? Because we've set our love upon him, because we dwell in the secret place of the Most High, and we shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. We will say of the Lord, he is my shield and my strength. Hallelujah. So those who abide in Christ, he abides in us. Jesus said, John chapter 15, abide in me and I'll abide in you, because apart from me, you can do nothing. You know, he's the vine, we are the branches. We are to abide in him that we might bear much fruit. So if you abide in Christ, if you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, if you set your love upon him, because he loves us, because of his mercy, he will vanquish our enemies. Not only our enemies, but the enemies of the church, the enemy of His. Hallelujah. So Lord, give me another text. I'm going to read this to you, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. You know, when you go to most churches, it's all about growing their kingdom and growing their denomination or growing their ministry. So they don't talk about the other things that Jesus said, you know, like when He got mad, cast out the money changers and all that. They don't usually get into those. Here's another text, and the Lord wanted me to read this to you tonight. This is nighttime here, Sunday morning there in the States. Luke 19, starting at verse, let's start with verse 10, because the Lord is saying, they got mad at Him because he went to the house of Zacchaeus, and Zacchaeus was a tax collector, and Zacchaeus repented, and the Lord said, you know, you're saved, you know, you're inherit the kingdom of heaven. People got mad because the guy was a tax collector. Jesus said, verse 10, you know, for the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which is lost. Verse 11, and as they heard these things, He added and spake a parable. Now I'm going to give you this parable from the Lord. Because He was nigh to Jerusalem, and because they thought that the kingdom of God should immediately appear. They thought the Lord, like they read the Bible, the reason why lots of Israelites reject Jesus as a Messiah is because they look at the verses about the second coming of Christ, which is about to happen, where He vanquishes His enemy and He rules and reigns from Jerusalem and all that. That's what they think is going to happen now. So when Jesus came the first time, if He was the Messiah, that's why they kept saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. It means victory to the Son of David. They thought, hey, He's coming to, you know, get rid of the Roman Empire and all that. Even His disciples, before the Lord ascended into heaven in Acts chapter 1, they asked Him, are You at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? They still didn't know that there was a gap. There was a gap that we know as the church age, brothers and sisters. There's a gap between the 69th week of Daniel and the 70th week. Right now, we've been in that. The age of grace, the church age, the year of Jubilee. It is a year of Jubilee in God's timing. It's not 1 year in earthly time, and it's the year of Jubilee, the year of grace, the age of grace, the church age, the time of the Gentiles, etc., etc., etc. All those different things. Listen to this. So verse 11, Luke 19, verse 11. And so they heard these things. He added and spake a parable because He was not in Jerusalem because they thought that the kingdom of heaven should immediately appear. And He said, therefore, a certain nobleman went into a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and to return. Which is what we're just doing right now. He's about to return. He's talking about Israel. And he called his 10 servants and delivered to them 10 pounds, saying to them, occupy till I come. Occupy till I come. That's what I'm trying to tell you. We're to occupy till the Lord returns. Not to run away and cower in fear from the enemy and you know, the devil's people that, you know, that's taken over the world, and Antifa and is one manifestation of that. The, you know, the gay marriage, whatever, all these things and imprisonment, whatever may befall Christians, persecution, when we stand against the enemy and stand for the Word of God, stand for what's true, and stand for the name of Jesus Christ. Fight the good fight of faith. Verse 14, but his citizens hated him and sent a message after him saying, we will not have this man to reign over us. Now that's Israel, but it's also the world too. And it came to pass that when he was returned, having received the kingdom, the Lord comes back at the end of the age, which hopefully it's going to be 7 years and just a little while, more than 7 years. Came to pass when he was returned, having received the kingdom, then he commanded these servants to be called unto him, to whom he had given the money, that he might know how much every man had gained by his trading. What have you done with the gifts God had given you? Then came the first, saying, Lord, thy pound has gained 10 pounds. And he said unto him, well, thou good and servant, because thou hast been faithful in very little, have thou authority over 10 cities. And the second came. The Bible says we will rule and reign with Christ for 1,000 years. This is an example of how we'll get to rule and reign, based on what we've done with what God has given us. That's a whole other message. That's the message that we usually talk about. But the message I'm talking to you tonight is, let God arise, let His enemies be scattered. Hallelujah. The enemies of God can't stand against His Word, brothers and sisters. It's a cliche. People say, oh, put on the armor of God, put on the armor of God. It's just a cliche for most people. It's like some abstract thing. I've been in the trenches, especially here in the Philippines. I've been in the trenches, and some of you have. Most of you, it's all in theory. You know, if you're not causing trouble for the enemy, he's not messing with you. You know, I've said this before years ago in videos. When I was a backslider, the enemy had me all jammed up with drinking and et cetera, and he didn't have to worry about me. You know, he didn't have to attack me because I had got myself entangled in my own, you know what, well, in my own web of nonsense, of sin. And so once you get loose from that, okay, but everybody, 90% of the people I talk to, it's about me, you know, they're getting loose and all that, but then what? We're supposed to be wreaking havoc in the enemy's camp. Hallelujah. For I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. Yes, I took back what he stole from me. Yes, I took back what he stole from me. Yes, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet. He's under your feet. The enemy, Satan, is under our feet in Jesus' name. That's what the Lord said. Hallelujah. Praise God. He's given us authority to tread over the top of snakes, demons, all those things, scorpions, things that would sting us, things that would normally bother us if we were in our flesh. But by the power of God, by the grace of God, by the love of God, those who have set their affections on Him, we've got Psalm 91, brothers and sisters. We've got the 23rd Psalm. Hallelujah, that the Lord would lead us beside the still water, that He would anoint our head with oil. Hallelujah, that He would lead us in paths of righteousness for His name's sake. And surely goodness and mercy, those angels, goodness and mercy, as I told you guys about in a video the other day, who saw it, those angels, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Hallelujah, the Shepherd's Psalm, 23rd Psalm, hallelujah, one of the best psalms, most famous ones written by the Spirit through King David, hallelujah. For another came, and the second guy, he gave him rule over five cities. Verse 20, and another came, saying, Lord, behold, here is thy pound, which I have kept laid up in a napkin. For I feared thee, because thou art an austere man, and thou takest up that thou layest not down, and reap where you didn't sow. And he said unto him, out of thine own mouth will I judge thee, thou wicked servant. Thou knewest I was an austere man, taking up what I did not lay down, and reaping where I did not sow. Therefore, or wherefore, that then givest not thou my money unto the bank. Why didn't you put my money in the bank? Or at least I would have got interest off of it. Let's say it in modern words. This is not the point of what I'm teaching you. This is in the middle of this parable. So we're to be faithful with what God gave us. The Lord is going to be angry if we, 90% of people in the church are not doing anything with the talents that God gave them. 10% maybe are doing, you know, they're multiplying the talents that the Lord gave them. People don't seem to care about that. People are all obsessed about what day the rapture is. Instead of, have I done what I've been called to do? Have I run the race God gave me to do? Have I borne the fruit that God told me to bear and created me to bear? Have I done God's will? Instead of obsessing about when you're going to escape, instead of being salt and light and occupying until He comes. Hallelujah. You're out of balance with what God wants us to do. Hallelujah. We're supposed to be working, but then keep glancing up, keep looking up, but continue to work until the sun goes down. You know, like the parable of the vineyard, the people that are working in the vineyard. You know, you work until it's dark and you can't see no more. That's the time that the wages are given, after the sun goes down. It's not completely dark yet. In your opinion, it might be dark, but it's not, because if it was, the Lord would have already taken us. The tribulation would have already begun. Those things haven't happened. There's still twilight. Obviously, what you need to pray, what people need to pray is, Lord, give me eyes that I might see thee, that I might see in the twilight. Hallelujah. And verse 24, and he said to them that stood by, take from him the pound, the 1 pound that he has, and give it to him that hath 10. And they said unto him, Lord, he hath 10 pounds. For I say unto you, that unto every one which hath shall be given, and for him that hath not, even that he what he's got will be taken away from him. And those mine enemies, this is the main part I wanted to teach today. Verse 27, and those mine enemies which would not that I should reign over them, bring hither and slay them before me. Hallelujah. Those are the kind of Bible verses that people, you know, Jesus is all love, God is love and all this. So I'll ask you this. The Lord asked me this, and then I asked all the Filipino churches I work with. No people got it right. And I've mentioned this in videos years ago. Is God's love conditional? Let's see if you've been brainwashed by the Laodicean church. Is God's love conditional? Okay, so most people would say, no, God's love is unconditional. Well, why do we need to be born again to enter the kingdom of heaven? If God's love is unconditional, why must we be born again to enter the kingdom of heaven? So see, God loves everybody. God so loved the world, but He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish but have everlasting life. So God does love all of His creation, but He is also going to cast them into hell. There are also people that are God's enemies. The Bible says that we are born as enemies and strangers of God. See, this is what you're not hearing in the churches. That's why people aren't getting saved, because they're not hearing the truth. People walk around and saying, God loves you. God so loved all of His creation the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever would receive his gospel, those who would believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, would pass from life unto death. They would inherit eternal life. The wrath of God would not remain on them. Jesus said, John chapter 3, after the John 3:16, in the same chapter, Jesus said, those who do not believe in him, the wrath of God remains on them. And there's plenty of Bible verses as a disquote. So when we're born into this world, it says we are enemies and strangers of God. And the wrath of God for our sin is upon us, each and every one of us, brothers and sisters. So until we're born again, then the Lord Jesus Christ becomes a propitiation, is the big theological term. The Lord becomes our advocate. His blood cleanses us. We're under the blood of Jesus. We're covered by his blood. We receive the righteousness of Christ. We give the Lord our sin, and we accept that the penalty, the wages for sin is death, the Bible says. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. You know, the Roman road, Romans 3:23, Romans 6:23. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus, brothers and sisters. So the Lord died in our place. So we accept the fact that we have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. When you take the Ten Commandments, as the Bible says, that the law is a schoolmaster to bring us to the knowledge of sin and death. So we hold up the Ten Commandments and we look at ourselves, as James said, beholding ourselves in a mirror. So I look at the Ten Commandments. It says, thou shalt not steal. Have I taken anything that doesn't belong to me? Yes, I have. Even if it was a piece of candy as a kid, yes, I've taken something that doesn't belong to me. Have you ever lied? The Bible says all liars have their place in the lake of fire. Have you ever told a lie? Yes, that makes you a liar. Have you ever looked on someone with lust? Jesus said you're an adulterer in your heart. That's a thieving, lying, adulterer. It's three already, brothers and sisters, right there that nearly 100% of people fall under. Right there. Maybe there's some people that never took something that didn't belong to them. Maybe, you know, a few. But the other ones, brothers and sisters, we've all sinned, the Bible says, and fallen short of the glory of God. So once we get the understanding by the standard of God, as I said, the Ten Commandments, you look at that, you see where you've fallen short. You're never going to meet God's perfect standard. The Bible says when you've broken one commandment, you've broken them all, the Bible says. The Bible says by the deeds of the law shall no flesh be justified. Brothers and sisters, we are indeed in need of a Savior. You know, Tom Cruise said he had a need for speed. But brothers and sisters, we have a need for the Lord Jesus Christ. We have a need for forgiveness. We have a need for the things of God. Hallelujah. We have a need for the incorruptible seed. Hallelujah. That one, the one and only begotten Son of the Most High God. Hallelujah. The incorruptible seed, the seed of the woman. Hallelujah. Genesis 3:15, the first prophecy in the Bible. Hallelujah, that the seed of the woman, the only person born that's not the seed of a man, but the seed of the woman, the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah, who loved us and gave himself for us. While we were yet sinners, he died for us. God demonstrated his love for all people, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Hallelujah. Jesus died for me before I repented. You see what I'm saying? Before you repented and before I repented, Jesus already had it all set up. God had it set up for us to receive grace, to repent, to receive to become born again, to become a child of God, to become an adopted son of God. Hallelujah. For it says in John chapter 1, you know, as many as received him, the Lord Jesus Christ, as many as believe on his name, to them he gave power to become the children of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you imagine what it's like to be a child of God? Can you get that through your head? We're not in the flesh. We're not children of this world. You know, your blood type changes to J. You know, your family name changes to Christian. Hallelujah. That's why back in those days, people say, what's your Christian name? You know, just like Peter, he was Simon, was his Hebrew name. Then Jesus changed his name to Cephas or Kepha, the rock. You know, Peter, Petros. And in English, it's Peter. Hallelujah. Praise God. The Lord changed his name. Hallelujah. That's his Christian name. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. The Lord has given us a name above every name. Hallelujah. That we are children of the King and we have authority in his name over all the power of the enemy, the Lord said. Hallelujah. We have power over all the power of the enemy. Why are you letting the enemy attack you and beat you down and scare you and run you off the battlefield? You know, and that's what the job of a minister. That's my job as a servant of the Most High God. I tell you, get back out on the field. What are you doing over here on the sideline crying and carrying on? Hallelujah. God is moved by one thing. Hallelujah. Read your Bible. God is moved by one thing. Hebrews 11:6. For without faith it's impossible to please God. You know, but He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. Hallelujah. Seek Him. Hallelujah. Have faith in God. Jesus said, with God all things are possible. Hallelujah. The Lord said that, you know, we can do all things through, the Bible says we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Hallelujah. John, 1 John 4:4, greater is He who's in me than he who's in the world. Hallelujah. Greater is He, the Spirit of the living God that's in me than he who's in the world. Satan, Lucifer, and all his little minions and all that. You know, even though we're, you know, especially, like I said, right here in the Philippines, surrounded by darkness on all sides, brothers and sisters, that easily besets us. Hallelujah. But I know my Redeemer lives. Hallelujah. I know my Redeemer lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know my Redeemer lives. He lives in me. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory for the things He has done. With His blood He has saved me. With His power He has raised me. To God be the glory for the things He has done. Yes, hallelujah. Worship Him. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. Great things He has done. I hadn't done anything, but what He's done? He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is to Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is to Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Hallelujah. That's an awesome song. I heard an old story. That's the beginning. How a Savior came from glory. How He made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. Hallelujah. He's awesome. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Hallelujah. He reigns forevermore. Jesus is the Lord who reigns forevermore. Hallelujah. Give Him praise, brothers and sisters. Jesus is the Lord who reigns forevermore. Hallelujah. He reigns. Yes, Lord. So reign over me, Lord. So reign over me, Lord. You are all that I want. You are all that I needed. I open my heart that You might come and reign over me, Lord. Why don't You reign over me? Sing with me, brothers and sisters. You are all that I want. You are all that I needed. I open my heart that You might come and reign over me, Lord. and reign over me, Lord. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. We bless your name, Most High God. Hallelujah. Lord, we enthrone you, Lord. Yes, Lord. We proclaim you our King, standing here in the midst of us. We lift you up with our praise, and as we worship, build your throne. And as we worship, build your throne. Come, Lord Jesus, and take your place. Hallelujah, Lord God. Yes, Lord. You are great. You are mighty. So we cry, Lord, you're worthy of all praise. Be exalted, our God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we magnify your name in this place, O Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, O Lord. Your name is great, and greatly to be praised, Lord my God. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. I speak the blessings of the Most High God upon you right now. I just speak right now and release the floodgates over your life right now. Open heaven in Jesus' name. I declare it and decree an open heaven over your life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Receive it right now by faith in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. As a prophet of the Most High God, I decree and declare open heaven over your life in Jesus' name. Receive it right now. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. And let it rain, let it rain. Yes, Lord. Jesus Christ, Son of the Most High God, El Elyon. Open the floodgates of heaven and let it rain, let it rain. Yes, Lord. Open the floodgates of heaven. And let it rain, yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Shema Israel. Hallelujah, Adonai, yes, Adonai, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God. We praise you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forevermore. Yes, sing it. Sing it to the Lord. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forevermore. Hallelujah. The Lord says, and through the prophet Jeremiah, I know the plans I have for you. It's to build you up and not to destroy you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord has plans for each and every one of you. Hallelujah. It's not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 For those who are in Christ are not condemned by any man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is now, therefore, no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk according to the Spirit and not according to the flesh. Hallelujah. For we are judged not by the flesh and the cardinal rules of men. Hallelujah. But we are judged by the Spirit of the living God. For the Spirit of the Lord, the eyes of the Lord, run to and fro throughout the earth. Hallelujah. Looking into the things that we do for his name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. See that you be found in Christ Jesus at the midnight hour. See you be found in the vineyard at the midnight hour. See that you be found with oil in your lamp at the midnight hour. Hallelujah. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be open. Hallelujah. Ask and you shall receive. Oil aplenty hath the Lord to give to those who ask, seek and knock. Hallelujah. You have not because you ask not. And you ask not because you asked amiss. Hallelujah. To consume on your own lust. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Create in us, O Lord, a pure heart and clean hands and a voice that has not been lifted unto another. Hallelujah. Forgive us clean hands. Give us pure hearts. And we have not lift our voice to another. Give us clean hands. Give us a pure heart. Yes, Lord. And we would not lift our voice to another. Hallelujah, Lord God. We bless you, Father, God Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. For you have given us the kingdom, Lord God. You have given the kingdom to people such as this. Hallelujah. Even as you said also, Lord, fear not, little flock, for it's the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for you have created us for such a time as this. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, God is mighty and good. Hallelujah. God is good, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Praise God. You know, we're almost out of here by the grace of God. We'll be out of here, brothers and sisters, soon. Hold fast to what God has given you. Be salt and light. Occupy till the Lord returns. Bear much fruit for His glory. And be ready. For you know not what hour the Master doth come. And when the Master comes, Matthew 25, make sure that you're busy about His business. Be busy about the business of the Father. And not your own business, brothers and sisters, but the business of the Father. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Brothers and sisters, I thank all you are praying for Joshua's ministry. Hallelujah. The Lord is cleaning house in Joshua's ministry too. Praise God. Praise God that we have lots of people working for Joshua's ministry, and the Lord would pluck out those who are not to be in the ministry and add to the ministry those who need to be here that's called to this Joshua's ministry. As for your prayers for that and about that, hallelujah, that God's will be done in Joshua's ministry. So we're in a period of cleaning house by the holiness of God, removing all unholy and unclean things from the ministry, brothers and sisters. So I have a pretty vast ministry here in the Philippines. Lots of churches that I work with. And so praise God for that, that the enemies of the Lord would be vanquished from the ministry too, brothers and sisters. Because the enemy tries to infiltrate any kind of church, any kind of ministry. You know, the devil's trying to get his head in there. We can't give place to the enemy, brothers and sisters, the Bible says. To chop off the head. Send the enemy back to the pit in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. For through Christ Jesus we have the victory. We have the authority. And we have the victory in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Over all the power of the enemy. Don't be afraid, brothers and sisters. Stand up. Speak up in the name of Jesus Christ. Speak up. Use that sword of the Spirit. Put on the armor of God. Don't back down. But stand strong in the Lord, in the power of His might, it says, Ephesians 6. There it talks about the armor of God. Be strong in the Lord, in the power of His might. Not your might or my might, but in the power of the Lord, in His might. Hallelujah. Stand in strong in the name of the Lord. Stand for what's right in the name of the Lord. Don't back down. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stand strong in the Lord, in the power of His might. That's what I'm going to do, been trying to do, and will continue to do. If you have a bad day, you back down, just repent of it and come back again the next day. You know, take a little time, take a day off and regroup, recharge, come back at it. Hallelujah. We've got victory in the name of the Lord, brothers and sisters. Just stand and God will do the rest. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Hallelujah. Stand still and see the Lord do the rest. Rest in Him. Hallelujah. Praise God. But stand by faith in Him. Hallelujah. Let Him use you as an instrument of righteousness. God bless you all.